Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the following question, which says, from a lot of 10 bulbs, which includes 3 defectives, a sample of 2 bulbs is drawn at random. Find the probability distribution of the number of defective bulbs. Before we move on to the solution, let's discuss the probability distribution of the random variable given by x, and the probability distribution is given as x, where x takes the values as x1, x2 and so on up to xn. Then p of x, that is the probability of the random variable x, takes the values p1, p2 and so on up to pn. So this is the probability distribution of the random variable x, where we have this pi is greater than 0 and summation of pi, I goes from 1 to n, is equal to 1. And the real numbers x1, x2 and so on up to xn are the possible values of the random variable x, and the small pi is the probability of the random variable x taking the value xi. So probability of x equal to xi is equal to pi. So this is how we get the probability distribution of a random variable. This is the key idea that we use for this question. Let's now move on to the solution. As in the question, we have that we are given a lot of 10 bulbs, out of which 3 bulbs are defective. So this means 10 minus 3, 7 bulbs would be good bulbs. And from this lot of 10 bulbs, a sample of 2 bulbs is drawn at random. We have to find the probability distribution of the number of defective bulbs. So we take, let x be the number of defective bulbs in the sample space. So in this case, our x is the random variable and we have to find the probability distribution of this x, which is the number of defective bulbs in the sample space. Now, as given in the key idea, we have that these real numbers x1, x2 and so on up to xn are the possible values of the random variable x. So let's see what would be the possible values of the random variable x. Now as we draw 2 bulbs from the lot of 10 bulbs, so these 2 bulbs could be defective, or either of the 2 bulbs would be defective, or none of them would be defective. So this means the random variable x can take the values 0, 1 or 2. Therefore we have, say, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 1 and x3 equal to 2. These are the 3 possible values of the random variable x. Now for the probability distribution, we have got the possible values of the random variable x. Now we are left to find the probability of the random variable x at each of these values of x1, x2 and x3. Now we have the total number of bulbs are given as 10, out of which 3 bulbs are defective, and so 7 bulbs would be good bulbs. Now first we consider x1 equal to 0. Let's find out the probability of the random variable x equal to x1, that is 0. This would be the probability that none of the drawn bulbs are defective. This means that the two bulbs which we draw are the good bulbs. So this would be equal to 7C2. So there are 7 good bulbs, and out of the 7 good bulbs we draw 2 bulbs. So 7C2 upon 10C2, as there are total of 10 bulbs out of which we draw 2 bulbs. This would be equal to 7 factorial upon 2 factorial into 7 minus 2, which is 5 factorial upon 10 factorial upon 2 factorial into 10 minus 2, that is 8 factorial. Further we get, this is equal to 7 into 6 upon 2 into 1, this one upon 10 into 9 upon 2 into 1. Now, this 2 into 1 cancels, and we have 7 into 6 upon 10 into 9. Now, 3, 2 times is 6, and 3, 3 times is 9, and 2, 5 times is 10. So this is equal to 7 upon 15, that is, the probability of the random variable x equal to 0 is equal to 7 upon 15. Next we have x2 equal to 1. So we now find out the probability of the random variable x at 1. So probability of x equal to 1 would be the same as the probability of drawing 1 defective and 1 good bulb. Now as we have 3 defective bulbs, so 3C1, since we draw 1 defective bulb out of the 3 defective bulbs, and this into 7C1, as there are 7 good bulbs and we draw 1 good bulb, and this whole upon 10C2, as we draw 2 bulbs from the lot of 10 bulbs. This is further equal to 3 factorial upon 1 factorial into 3 minus 1, that is 2 factorial, this into 7 factorial upon 1 factorial into 7 minus 1, that is 6 factorial, and this one upon 10 factorial upon 2 factorial into 10 minus 2, that is 8 factorial. This gives us 3 upon 1 into 7 upon 1, this one upon 10 into 9 upon 2 into 1. Now, 2, 5 times is 10, 3, 3 times is 9, so we get this equal to 7 upon 5 into 3, that is 15. So, probability of the random variable x at 1 is equal to 7 upon 15. Then we consider x3 equal to 2. So we now find out the probability of the random variable x equal to x3, which is 2. This would be same as the probability of drawing both defective bulbs. As there are 3 defective bulbs, so it would be 3C2 upon 10C2, as there are total of 10 bulbs. So further, this would be equal to 3 factorial upon 2 factorial into 3 minus 2, that is 1 factorial, this whole upon 10 factorial upon 2 factorial into 10 minus 2, that is 8 factorial. This gives us 3 upon 1, this one upon 10 into 9 upon 2 into 1. Now here, 2, 5 times is 10, 3, 3 times is 9, so this is equal to 1 upon 15. That is, we have probability of the random variable x equal to 2 is equal to 1 upon 15. Now we can easily write the probability distribution of the random variable x. Now we have three values for the random variable x as 0, 1 and 2. For x equal to 0, the probability is given as 7 upon 15. So we write here 7 upon 15. For x equal to 1, the probability is given as 7 upon 15. So again, we write here 7 upon 15. Then for x equal to 2, the probability is given as 1 upon 15. So here we have 1 upon 15. So this is the required probability distribution of the random variable x, where this x is the number of defective bulbs in the sample space. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.